Spirit within you, says the Lord.
So prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Pray. O God, author of every mercy and of all goodness, who in fasting, prayer, and almsgiving have shown us a remedy for sin, look graciously on this confession of our lowliness, that we, who are bowed down by our conscience, may always be lifted up by your mercy. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. In those days, in their thirst for water, the people grumbled against Moses, saying, "Why did you ever make us leave Egypt? Was it just to have us die here of thirst with our children and our livestock?" So Moses cried out to the Lord, "What shall I do with this people? A little more and they will stone me." The Lord answered Moses, "Go over there in front of the people along with some of the elders of Israel, holding in your hand as you go the staff with which you struck the river. I will be standing there in front of you on the rock in Horeb. Strike the rock, and the water will flow from it for the people to drink." This Moses did in the presence of the elders of Israel. The place was called Massah and Meribah, because the Israelites quarreled there and tested the Lord, saying, "Is the Lord in our midst or not?" the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, since we have been justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have gained access by faith to this grace in which we stand, and we boast in hope of the glory of God. And hope does not disappoint, because the love of God has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who has been given to us. For Christ, while we were still helpless, died at the appointed time for the ungodly. Indeed, only with difficulty does one die for a just person, though perhaps for a good person, one might even find courage to die. But God proves his love for us, and that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Father, may I have your blessing.
May the Lord be in her and with you. We will thank you, God.
Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. are truly the Savior of the world. Give me living water that I may never thirst again. Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus came to a town of Samaria called Sychar, near the plot of land that Jacob had given to his son Joseph. Jacob's well was there. Jesus, tired from his journey, sat down there at the well. It was about noon. A woman of Samaria came to draw water. Jesus said to her, "Give me a drink." His disciples had gone into the town to buy food. The Samaritan woman said to him, "How can you, a Jew, ask me, a Samaritan woman, for a drink? For Jews use nothing in common with Samaritans." Jesus answered and said to her, "If you knew the gift of God and who is saying to you, 'Give me a drink,' you would have asked him, and he would have given you living water." The woman said to him, "Sir, you do not even have a bucket, and the cistern is deep. Where then can you get this living water? Are you greater than our father Jacob, who gave us the cistern and drank from it himself, with his children and his flocks?" Jesus answered and said to her, "Everyone who drinks this water will be thirsty again. But whoever drinks the water I shall give will never thirst. The water I shall give will become in him a spring of water welling up to eternal life." The woman said to him, "Sir, give me this water so that I may not be thirsty or have to keep coming here to draw water. I can see that you are a prophet. Our ancestors worshipped on this mountain, but you people say that the place to worship is in Jerusalem." Jesus said to her, "Believe me, woman, the hour is coming when you will worship the Father neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem. You people worship what you do not understand. We worship what we understand, because salvation is from the Jews. But the hour is coming, and is now here, when true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and truth. And indeed, the Father seeks such people to worship him. God is spirit, and those who worship him must worship in spirit and truth." The woman said to him, "I know the Messiah is coming, the one called the Christ. When he comes, he will tell us everything." Jesus said to her, "I am he, the one who is speaking with you." Many of the Samaritans of that town began to believe in him. When the Samaritans came to him, they invited him to stay with them, and he stayed there 2 days. Many more began to believe in him because of his word, and they said to the woman, "We no longer believe because of your word, for we have heard for ourselves, and we know that this is truly the Savior of the world." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ. This weekend, I'm giving a public service address connected with the pandemic, so please listen. The things I'm saying are precautions that we need to take as a parish and the other parishes in different parts of the country, some of which are actually closed up, so we're still allowed to have mass. I don't know how long that will go on, but you have to stay tuned to the website of the parish and other media outlets to find out any developments. The understanding behind the precautions that I'll be explaining has to do with slowing the spread of the disease. Now, the thing about the coronavirus, from what I understand, is people at most at risk are older people, people who are compromised health-wise to begin with. The other thing which makes it particularly insidious is that people can be carriers of the virus and not really manifest symptoms. Especially young people, even children, can carry the virus. So that's the background from which I'm speaking. The government of the state has indicated people should use common sense by means of, you know, what they call social distancing. They're asking people to stand in such a way or that there's 6 feet apart from others. And any activities of the church or the school or what have you, or other institutions, should be carried on with the greatest care and sensitivity. With that in mind, the diocese has enjoined the following: the elimination of holy water by the doors of the churches, and the use of the chalice for distribution of the precious blood to be discontinued. Now, I must tell you that the body and blood of Jesus is present under each form. So if you don't take from the chalice, you're still getting the body and blood of Jesus from the host. Physical contact during the sign of peace, there shouldn't be any, but what's actually going to happen is there will not be a sign of peace for that reason. Priests are enjoined, and deacons and so forth, not to shake hands after Mass. I know there was a minister who shook hands with 500 people. Apparently, he was infected or what have you. And I'm not claiming I'm infected, but with the shaking of hands, what happens is you have a great deal of physical contact involving many people. Which normally is fine, it's good, but under these circumstances, it can be problematic. People who are sick, and there may be a few among us today, I ask you very respectfully not to come to church. With people with compromised immune systems, for your own protection, for that of others. The rest of us, avoid close contact, especially with people who are sick. If a person has to sneeze or whatever, please use tissue or Kleenex and what have you. Please wash hands properly. Be careful about touching things, surfaces that could have germs and so forth. Again, older people and people with chronic illnesses are at greater risk. So we have to be careful, especially about the elderly. Now, while the option of receiving the body of Christ on the tongue or hand is still in effect, we ask respectfully that people receive in the hand. If people insist on receiving on the tongue, then please to wait until the end of the communion line. Again, this is for health reasons. We are taking our time with other important decisions that do not have to be made right now. For example, the timeline for First Holy Communion or confirmation. I really don't have a report to give you there, but we're staying tuned to further developments. Nursing homes. Some people from the parish, Legion of Mary, or ministers of Holy Communion are visiting several nursing homes in the parish. Is no longer permitted. And because nursing homes, I've been told by the state of Ohio, actually by the president, I should say, that people in the nursing homes are really not to receive more than one visitor in one day. And I'm just saying it, so I don't want people from the parish going to local nursing homes in representing the parish. Now, probably what will happen if they do try to go, they won't be allowed to come in. If anybody is sick and needs to go to the hospital or whatever, see the priest for sacrament of the sick before you go. For example, I'm on emergency coverage for the TriPoint Hospital today. As of tomorrow, and I'm not on duty there anymore tomorrow, but supposedly the hospitals are going to have something in place such that it's not even easy for a priest to get into the hospital to see people. So I'm just telling you what's happening. I don't want to incite panic. That isn't the point. It's just know what's going on and take proper precautions. Here's a decree that was issued on the 13th of March by Father Alexiak, who's the diocesan administrator. He's taking the place of a bishop. We don't have a bishop right now. Due to the current health emergency, for the safety of the people of the Diocese of Cleveland, I hereby dispense with the obligation to attend Sunday Mass on this weekend, next weekend, and the following weekend. All those who live in Catholics who live in Ohio or are here, you know, part time, or traveling Catholics and so forth. I encourage all, especially those who do not attend Mass on these days, to set aside each weekend a time of prayer and a personal sacrifice for those who are seriously ill or adversely affected anyway by the present crisis. Now, I will be having Masses here on those weekends. It's just that if people are dispensed from going, we're not trying to discourage people from coming to Mass, but we're trying to open the door to people who are, let's say, compromised in their health and whatnot. And even in normal conditions, sick people are not required to come to Mass. So it's not a sin if you're sick and it's a Sunday and you can't come to Mass. Now there is a dispensation for this Sunday and the following two. Now what will happen after the following two Sundays, I don't know. So far things are on track, but it's hard to say. Some dioceses have canceled Mass altogether. Again, I don't have a crystal ball. I really don't know what's going to happen, but I'm just trying to present a picture here. Certain things in our parish we've had to cancel. Friday fish bakes, canceled. Somebody reported us to the health department yesterday because we didn't take down the fish bake sign fast enough, and we got a call. What are you doing having a fish bake there? So, you know, this is not just Father Donnelly doing some crazy things. You know, I only work here, you know what I'm saying? Exactly. So until further notice, RCIA will not be meeting. No PSR until after Easter. Again, pending developments. Bereavement canceled until next month. And no choir practice, and so forth. AA meeting for Wednesday nights canceled 18th and the 25th of March. So these are some things. Now, you know, what's still going on, Stations of the Cross on Fridays. We still have Masses, thank God, confessions. And we have a couple of, or several study series taking place. They're still going on. And now, again, some of this could change. So, but I'm just telling you, you know, for the time being, what's happening. As Christians, this Lenten season affords us an opportunity to bring all things to God as we seek to faithfully love and serve the Lord and one another. Please join us in praying for all those affected by the virus. May we have open minds and hearts to seek and to follow God's will in service to one another and to the common good. To keep aware of what's happening, websites, you can check World Health Organization, Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, Governor of Ohio, Diocese of Cleveland. And one final thought, we put our trust in Jesus Christ, who's conquered sin and death by the power of his cross and resurrection. In him is our hope and our sure protection. We pray for those who are infected and for all who are working for a cure and the protection of others. Thank you for your consideration. In our dear Father's love and providential care, let us bring to him the following petitions.
That Christians everywhere may respond to the word of God during this holy season, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that God's people may worship him in spirit and truth and reject the temptations of evil, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have rejected God may turn to him and know his loving mercy in their lives, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That through sincere confession of their own sins, those gathered here may be at peace with God and one another, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our sick, especially Tina Gerard, Don Majernik, Dan Rusnak, Jane Dursick, and Rose Hutchinson, as well as those who are listed in the bulletin, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the water of the Spirit welling up to eternal life may purify our dead, especially John Dobrzynski Sr. and Ralph DiNardo. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we are grateful. Please hear these prayers and also our prayers for the eternal welfare of Herbert Hoffman. We pray these things through your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Jesus walked this long time.
are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come, until you
celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Supper of the Lamb. Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. As we receive the pledge of things yet hidden in heaven and are nourished while still on earth with the bread that comes from on high, we humbly entreat you, O Lord, that what is being wrought about us in mystery may come to true completion through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The night's Columbus breakfast buffet is canceled, and as I said, the bereavement session scheduled for this evening is also canceled. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael, angel, defend us in battle. Protect against wickedness, there, devil.
May God rebuke him.
Filling our hearts with the joy.